The real world isn't perfect, so to achieve realism in your SOLIDWORKS Visualize renders, it can help to apply imperfections. Using appearance texture options, we can add scratches, smudges, and adjust reflectivity to bring our renders closer to the real deal. SOLIDWORKS Visualize 2024 introduces more appearance customization options than ever before. New DSPBR appearances allow you to get the most realistic looking renders possible. PBR, or physically based rendering materials, use real-world physics to calculate how lighting will react. They are composed of 5 separate texture maps, with 2 main variants for metallic and dielectric, or non-metallic appearances. To learn more about how PBR materials work, check out our explanation blog here. When creating a new appearance, the number of editable options can become intimidating at first, but using the appearance type dropdown, we can begin by selecting the type of material we are trying to replicate, such as leather or wood. Once selected, the list of available parameters will be narrowed down to the relevant ones only. For a deep dive into each of the available options, watch this guide. To control light reflectivity on a surface, we can adjust roughness. Using the roughness slider alone will control the reflectivity across the entire region the appearance is applied, allowing you to create a matte finish. However, the roughness map file will give you specific regions of lower reflectivity, such as surface defects under casting. Like most texture files, a roughness map will exist in the form of an image file, where darker areas will form duller regions and lighter zones will have increased reflectivity. There are multiple websites online which offer a range of free and paid for texture files, which you might need for your SOLIDWORKS renders. Since these are third-party sites, download any files at your own risk. Once a texture map of any type has been added to a parameter, it can be further modified in the texture and texture mapping tabs. Be sure to use the relevant mapping type for the surface you're applying to. The texture mapping tab is unique to each surface where the appearance is applied to offer greater control. It is also important to differentiate appearances between parts when working with materials such as wood. By changing the positional values on the texture mapping tab, you can reposition the appearance on each part to avoid identical textures on components made from the same material. Certain materials such as leather or wood grain may have texture which we would like to see. This could be added using a normal or displacement file. Normal and displacement parameters don't have a slider assigned, but they can have image files attached to control the visual appearance of bumps and dents. A normal file will provide the illusion of surface imperfections by manipulating lighting. The RGB components in the image correspond to XYZ coordinates of a surface. A good example of this would be a tread plate. However, if someone looks at your model from a steep angle, they may notice that the surface is not actually bumpy. An alternative is to use a displacement map. These grayscale images physically displace vertices on the surface to show bumps. However, displacement textures can lead to unexpected results if a surface has very few vertices, and they will take longer to render, so in most cases, a normal map is preferred. Both parameters can have their depth modified in the texture tab to exaggerate the effect if required. We could also include scratches or dents in your appearances by downloading a relevant texture file. Before we continue, if you're looking to level up your rendering skills, consider attending one of our SOLIDWORKS Visualize training courses with an expert instructor. Here you will learn to master lighting and appearances to create truly stunning renders. If you're looking to show a specific imperfection on your model, such as a fingerprint or splash of mud, it might be best to use a decal. This way you can manipulate the size and position of the imperfection without it duplicating across faces. Drag and reposition your decal, and then assign a material to it by dragging and dropping to control parameters such as opacity and roughness. In this case, we will reduce the opacity of the fingerprint decal using a basic appearance. If this video has got you excited to learn more about SOLIDWORKS Visualize, check out our top 3 ways to make your SOLIDWORKS Visualize renders more realistic here. Be sure to bookmark our blog, website, and YouTube channel, and check back soon for more SOLIDWORKS tips, tricks, and tutorials.